Hi everyone. When is the best time to harvest Pismo clams? In this video, I'll give you my thoughts about this question based on what I've learned about red tides, clam reproduction, low tides, and from personal experience. Please stay tuned. There's an old wives' tale that shellfish should only be eaten in months with the letter R. In the Northern Hemisphere, those months coincide with the fall to early spring, that is September to April. The origin dates back hundreds of years when shellfish were prone to spoilage during the hot summer months. This is no longer a problem with modern refrigeration. Pismo clamming regulations reflect this, as clams are allowed to be taken year-round according to the California Department of Fish and Wildlife. The exception is Monterey and Santa Cruz counties, where the season is September to April. Since 1947, Pismo clams have not been sold commercially in California. Pismo clams are essentially wild, so in order to eat this mollusk, one must forage for them on sandy beaches. For more information on clamming regulations, check the link in the description. Governmental regulations and commercial policies for safe consumption of Pismo clams do not exist. Therefore, the burden falls on the recreational clammer to responsibly catch and safely consume Pismo clams. A phenomenon that sometimes occurs from spring to late summer in calm and warmer waters of California are red tides. During a red tide, microscopic phytoplankton rapidly reproduce, causing a bloom. The ocean water can appear reddish or brownish in color. A bloom of specific phytoplankton species can cause elevated levels of a biotoxin, which can lead to paralytic shellfish poisoning, or PSP, in humans. Clammers should be cautious to take Pismo clams during a red tide to avoid the possibility of contracting PSP. In mild cases, symptoms include vomiting, diarrhea, and abdominal cramps. Fortunately, the California Department of Public Health monitors PSP and biotoxins in bivalves like Pismo clams on their website. The program recommends checking the biotoxin advisory before recreationally harvesting and consuming shellfish, including Pismo clams. The links are provided in the description. Cooking and freezing does not destroy paralytic shellfish poison and remains in the tissue of the shellfish. However, clams should always be frozen and/or cooked to eliminate the possible risk of illness from parasites and bacteria. Pismo clams begin their reproductive cycle by spawning in mid to late summer. During this time, clams release gametes, that is sperm and eggs, into the water. After fertilization, larvae settle in the intertidal zone on sandy beaches and continue to develop and grow. The growth of Pismo clams range from 1/2 to 3/4 of an inch a year. A Pismo clam reaches legal size of 4.5 inches in diameter and 5 inches in Monterey and Santa Cruz counties in around 9 years. In our opinion, it is not advisable to catch and consume Pismo clams during reproduction for a couple of reasons. First, the clams may not be as palatable because the clam's energy is focused on reproduction, not growth. The quality of the meat may be compromised for this reason. Second, and most importantly, reproduction during the summer months is a time for the replenishment of the clam population and vital for the future sustainability of the fishery. Pismo clams should be allowed to reproduce undeterred during this stage. Pismo clams can be found in the intertidal and subtidal zones. The intertidal zone is the area between the low and high tide marks. The subtidal zone is beyond the low tide mark and is always underwater. Studies have shown that clam size increases from smaller clams in the intertidal zone to larger clams in the subtidal zone. In other words, clams are bigger the further out toward the water you go. This makes sense, as most clams are taken in shallower water by recreational clammers and non-human predators. Extreme low tides, that is negative low tides, allow clammers to reach the best areas to find larger sized clams. The lowest tides occur in the winter months. Is the old wives' tale true? No, if the reason is because of spoilage. However, we believe the best time to harvest Pismo clams is from late fall to late winter, months with the letter R. Warmer summer ocean temperatures give way to colder winter temperatures, thus lessening the likelihood of red tides and chances of contracting paralytic shellfish poisoning. Clams have finished their reproductive stage of development as the offspring grow and develop to sustain future generations. Lastly, winter low tides work in favor of clammers, providing better access to legal-sized and bigger clams. Knowing when to dig for Pismo clams will improve chances of successfully harvesting legal-sized clams. So there you have it. These are my thoughts about the best time to harvest Pismo clams. I hope you found this video helpful. Please consider liking and sharing this video with people you know. Please consider subscribing to our channel. We would really appreciate your support. And as always, thank you so much for watching.